हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू अव्यान आईएएस एकेडमी। माय नेम इज अक्षता गर्ग एंड इफ यू आर एस्पायरिंग फॉर नेट जेआरएफ मैनेजमेंट सो यू हैव नॉक्ड द राइट विंडो। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द एलिजिबिलिटी क्राइटेरिया, हाउ द पेपर इज कंडक्टेड, द मोड ऑफ द पेपर एंड ऑल्सो द पार्टीशंस ऑफ हाउ द पेपर इज कंडक्टेड। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। So this UGC NET Management, NET JRF, this is the paper which is conducted by NTA on behalf of UGC. So today we are going to, in this video, we are going to understand all the complete criterias and also the elaborated syllabus of UGC Management, which is code number 17. So this paper consists of two partition, paper 1 and paper 2. So both the partitions have 50 and 100 questions respectively. So each question is marked by positive 2 marks and we have no negative markings in it. So it constitute, if we have 50 questions, so the marking becomes 100, and if we have 100 questions, the marking becomes 200. So if we talk about the eligibility criteria, that who all are the students, so many of you must be thinking that if we are eligible to give this exam. So of course we are here to provide you the clarity. So the criteria for JRF, so as per 1st March 2021, the revised amendment, we have the age upper limit of 31 years for JRF, which was 30 years earlier, and there is no upper limit for NET in any of the subjects being conducted by NTA. So if you talk about who all could pursue for this, so who all are aspiring to go for assistant professorship, or who are aspiring to have their future in research further, so they can definitely go for UGC NET JRF. So if you talk about the conduct, the mode in which the paper is conducted, so definitely it is the online mode, and the paper is conducted biannually. So June and December of each year the paper is conducted. Paper is of 180 marks. So earlier the division has to be there for paper 1 and paper 2 separately, but from few years it is collective 180 minutes, with wherein you can shift to your windows whichever paper you want to do first. So let's have a look on what all the new units and what is the syllabus of paper 1, and then we'll be jumping on the paper 2. So paper 1, we have the bifurcations in 10 units. First unit is teaching aptitude. So paper 1 basically talks about general topics wherein we have to consume with basic ethics and morals of how we will be entering into a profession of education, how will we be entering into the profession of assistant professor. So this all are the basic knowledge that gives a idea of aptitude of an individual. So first unit is teaching aptitude, followed by research aptitude, then we have reading comprehension. Unit 4th, we have communication. Unit 5th, we have mathematical reasoning, wherein we get the solving questions, maths questions related to. We have numbers, we have number series, we have speed, distance, time questions, we have n number of questions that comes into mathematical reasoning. Followed by unit 6, we have logical reasoning. So logical reasoning includes of all the topics related to wherein logic is involved, wherein rational decision has to be taken, which involves all the arguments, definitions we have. We have Indian logic also in it. So then we have this unit 7 of data interpretation. Unit 8 is ICT. Unit 9 is people and environment. And unit 10 comprises of higher education. So if we talk about paper 1 particularly, if you have given a good time to paper 1 in studying paper 1, it is quite scoring, and even a general paper which you usually encounter, if you give any of the papers, maybe UPSC, maybe IAS, or any of the entrances of PhD. Moving on to our subjective paper, that is paper 2, though all the papers are objective, but yes, this is, we are talking about code number 17, which is management. So again, the entire syllabus is bifurcated and divided into 10 units. And 10 units, though it is 10 units, but it has multiple combinations of topic. It has combinations of multiple topics. So unit 1 comprises of, we have business management, plus it has the topics of business ethics, plus it has the topics of business economics. So it comprises of whole sum, it comprises of unit 1. Then unit 2 is talking about organization behavior, wherein we understand the individual behavior in an organization and group behavior in an organization, plus the topics from HRM. So HRM, we can have job analysis, we can have job description, we can have job specification, we can have job evaluation, training and development, and so on. Moving on to our third unit, we have strategic human resource management. So basically, strategic human resource management and HRM. So strategic human resource management, we are understanding how can we imply the human resource management strategically to align the objectives with the objective of the organization. Plus, we understand some of the aspects and theories from industrial relations. Unit 4 comprising of accounting plus financial management. So what all comes under financial management? We have cost of capital, we have capital structure, we have capital budgeting, and so on. Followed by unit 5. So we have the followed portion of financial management in unit 5 also, which is comprising more of topics from portfolio management. So here we come for CAPM. We come across derivatives, we come across some of the topics from value and return, and so on. Followed by some of the portions from working capital and foreign exchange market. If we come upon unit 6, so we have the combination of topics from strategic marketing and marketing. So which includes of all the marketing mix. We have product, price, promotion, and we have product, price, promotion, and place. And strategic management mein we are going to understand BCG metrics kya hota hai hamara 9 cell McKinsey kya hota hai. We understand from the perspective of the firm and in the industry. So unit 7 comprises of consumer behavior, the different terminologies that are there in consumer behavior, and also the theories which from where the questions are more often asked. We have supply chain management, we have something from customer relationship management, and also an element of e-marketing. Coming on to our unit 8, we have statistics, we have production management, and we have OR with us, comprising various topics from unit 8. In statistics, we have central tendency, we learn dispersion, we learn correlation, regression. In production management, we learn process layout kya hota hai, product layout kya hai, also the associated terminologies. And OR, we learn transportation problem, queen theory, CPM, PERT, ye sari cheeze hamare OR mein cover hoti hai. This is operation research basically. So if we come down on unit 9, so it is the integration of IB, international business, and information technology. So हमारा international business में भी बहुत सारी चीज़ें आती हैं. हमारे modes of entry क्या हैं, हमारे international business में theories क्या हैं, हमारे बहुत सारे aspects आ जाते हैं BOP के, हमारा FDI आ जाता है, types of FDI आ जाता है, and also financial institute जिसमें कि you more often questions are asked. हमारा WTO हो गया, Exim policy हो गया, ASEAN हो गया, SAARC हो गया, बहुत सारे financial institutions होते हैं जो हमें इसमें पढ़ने होते हैं. Then comes unit 10. Unit 10 is basically comprising of whole soul entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship में हम पढ़ते हैं basically three types of entrepreneurs. So what entrepreneurs? Different definitions given by different authors. Entrepreneur क्या होता है? Women entrepreneur क्या होता है? And rural entrepreneur क्या होता है? इनके causes, इनके factors and everything. And also the very important topic or portion of this unit is government scheme, जिसमें से at least two questions are compulsory to come. So this was basically the idea of Net JRF management. ये हमारा paper 1 का complete syllabus है, ये हमारा paper 2 का complete syllabus है, जिसमें कि we have also seen the internal integral part of the units. So if I tell you that जो हमारा अभी last paper हुआ था June 2020, so Net का cutoff if we see that was 56.67, and जो हमारा JRF का cutoff गया है that was 64.67. May में हमारा दिसंबर 2020 का एग्जाम टू बी हेल्ड. इट इज़ फ्रॉम 2 to 17 मे. सो इफ यू हैव फिल्ड द फॉर्म एंड यू आर लुकिंग फॉर समथिंग टू लर्न फ्रॉम, यू हैव नॉट द राइट विंडो. वील बी वेटिंग फॉर यू टू एनरोल एट अव्यान IAS Academy. थैंक यू सो मच.